open the floor now. We'll start with Eden Santos, net 25. The secretary is also on a tight schedule, so we'll keep it brief.
Secretary, good afternoon po. Last time po nabanggit na yung tubig sa Puerto Galera ay medyo not good for swimming na po. Pero sabi po ng DOH, so far hindi pa kasama yung Puerto Galera dun sa tinitest talaga. So yung ginawa po ng provincial government doon, sila yung nagsagawa ng mga test sa pamumuno po ni Governor Bonds. Do you share the same opinion or stand po with the DOH na hindi pa dapat i-ban ang water activities sa Puerto Galera?
Thank you po, ma'am. I know that there is a statement from the DOH and the DNR that will be released or just has been released, no? Just to make a point of clarification, sa Puerto Galera po, we have a total of 35 water sampling stations, no? Of these, 6 were pre-existing kasi po Puerto Galera has a water quality management board, no? And so we have results from those 35 stations. There is a protocol, syempre po, dito sa pag-test po natin. And of the 35 stations, 9 stations lang po ang pumasa. On the declaration of whether there is safety for different types of activities po, that is really DOH's purview. Ang gawain po ng DNR is really to test the water, and our tests are for oil and grease in the water. At yun po yung nagawa namin. No? So that has already been shared with the different agencies.
Okay. Next question.
Follow-up na lang po muna.
Since wala akong magtanong.
Okay, go ahead. So ibig sabihin po, ma'am, ngayon po tuloy-tuloy pa rin ang swimming activity doon, yung ibang mga water activities sa Puerto Galera. Alam po natin ito isa sa mga tourist destinations sa ating bansa. And how will it affect po yung tourist activities po doon if in case na we're planning to ban it in the next few days or months?
Ma'am, thank you. Difficult for me to speculate about the banning po, no? But what I will say is we have reported na sa 35 na total, 26 po yung bumagsak. 9 ang pumasa, no? So, on the decision, on the governance of this risk, ano po, this is really a decision really and a pronouncement that the DOH will have to make. And of course, the local governments will hopefully also take notice of this po.
Okay. Doon po sa mga bumagsak, ano po ang mga bawal na activities doon?
So oil and grease po, of course, there is a concern in terms of ingestion. And so I will leave that po to the DOH kasi public health and public safety po. Sila po ang magpo-pronounce kung anong bawal at anong hindi. Ang sa amin po sa DNR is testing for the presence and the threshold, at kung may nag-exceed, iyon po ang i-report po namin.
Thank you.
Thank you po.
Job Manahan, ABS-CBN Online.
Hi, ma'am. You mentioned kanina na only 9 areas passed the water quality tests. So ano po yung measures na ginagawa to help clean yung other areas? And ilan po kaya yung months na tinitingnan to help clean up?
Let me just speak to the issue of the oil spill in general and the cleanup, no? At this point kasi po, we know that there's oil and grease in that water. At this point, what we know is there is an oil spill that is ongoing. And so what we anticipate po is for as long as the oil continues to leak, and that is being brought under control already effectively now, there will be transport of that oil, no? And that oil in particular will need some remediation for the ecosystems that are within the DNR's mandate to protect. There are some ecosystems that could be badly affected. We need to go into the water to actually see whether or not corals have been coated, for example. And unfortunately, we're not able to do that yet, no? but the DNR has the capacity to go down there. We have the divers, we have an ROV, and we need to actually have physical confirmation of the range of the actual impact in order for us to say, makaka-recover ba, gaano ba katagal, etc. No? What we are very pleased about, and I have to say this to share with you all, is the different municipalities have really come together under the leadership of the governor. No? They have been able to prevent some of the flows, no, that really coming in the general direction by building their own natural spill booms, no? And these are very effective in terms of absorbing and diverting any oil. And so we're very glad that we are able to assist also in this activity due to the actual technical expertise and mechanical, no, intervention that was given by some of the donors who actually helped us to decorticate coconut fiber and use that material actually to be part of the absorbent material for the oil spill. No? So in terms of months, po, it's very difficult for us to say at this point how long. We would like to be able to say for certain when the final leaks will be capped, and that still is being processed now. And so what we would like to say is at this point, let's take a look. Now, hopefully within the month or so, the leakage will probably be contained definitely. And we will actually be able to say what kind of damage has been incurred in the ecosystems that are submerged in the water. When it comes to the waters on the shoreline, we will continuously test, no, for the presence of any kind of contaminants. And that we will be there, I think, much longer than other agencies, mm-hmm. because the ecosystem impacts are actually long-term.
Mm-hmm. Ma'am, follow-up lang po. That sabi ng PSG on March 20 na may oil spill traces na daw po sa Isla Verde, PCG.
Yes po.
And then, ma'am, with this po kaya, ma'am, may confirmation about the impact ng oil spill dun sa Isla Verde?
May visual presence, that's why they were able to confirm. Ano po. The impact analysis is something that we continue to undertake, and I just wanted to share that we're able to do this with the help of our partners on the ground. There are NGOs working with us as well. We're using also evaluation method that we are taking off and referencing from the original Tubataha damage, if you remember. There was an economic valuation for the ecosystem loss that happened because of that incident. So we are tapping those experts. We also have the help of NOAA, the US NOAA, and USAID, as well as various NGOs that are helping us on the valuation. So sa Isla Verde po, may visual and of course may physical confirmation na nandun na. I just also wanted to add that, you know, on a daily basis, when we were at the height of the incident, we were getting very, very good support from the UP Marine Science Institute. Without them, the local scientists were able to help us with anticipating the possible trajectory of the oil. And that's how we were able to somehow alert some of the municipalities. Na baka po, given the wind and given the current, okay, baka maabutan po kayo.
Okay, thank you, Job. Vince Lopez, Manila Standard.
Ma'am, good afternoon po. May figures na po ba tayo on how much po yung total damage ng oil spill in terms po sa ating natural and environment resources po?
We have a reference figure for the valuation of the possible areas for contamination. I made this very clear po also on Saturday. Unless we have the physical confirmation, and ang kailangan po, we have to go down there and take a look. And then the valuation can be refined. But certainly po, as you can imagine, then the hectareage of the coral areas, the seagrass areas, is quite large. Now, confirmation to as to what extent na naabutan po sila at na-impact po sila, we need to go down there into the water to actually do it. So we're hoping to be able to do that fairly soon. Kasi po ngayon, hindi pa allowed po yung pagbaba sa tubig ngayon. Thank you po.
Okay, thank you very much. I think that's all we have.
No El Nino question.
We've just had our briefing this morning on El Nino. So thank you very much, Malacanang Press Corps. At magbabalik tayo in a few minutes for another briefing.